Hello students, welcome to the video lecture series on electrical installation, maintenance and testing. In the last class, we have discussed the important concept that is called as insulation deterioration, and we have discussed the various reasons why the insulation deteriorates. So almost we have seen the six causes or the reasons of failure of insulation, and one can think that because of the heat developed inside the electrical equipment is a major reason of the insulation failure or insulation deterioration. Today we are interested for one index that is called as a polarization. No doubt this polarization term which we have discussed in the insulator chapter of the course material science in the second year first semester. So let's go to today's topic, that is called as a polarization index. It is abbreviated as PI also. So we will discuss what is the purpose of this PI and how to measure this PI. The polarization index is used to determine the fitness of a motor or generator for use. The index is derived from calculating the measurement of the winding, insulation resistance. The polarization index gives an indication of the buildup of dirt or moisture. The deterioration of insulation and suitability for operation of the motor or generator. The testing of polarization index is a safety measure for electrical equipment. So this is related to the polarization index. Now the preparation and the procedure for testing. The reading that is significant to the polarization index is the insulation resistance. Before measuring the resistance, you should remove all the connections of the machine and discharge the windings, that is electric wire, to the grounded machine frame. By using a direct indicating power driven mega ohm meter, that is called an electrical test instrument producing a DC voltage, an electrical current of either 500 or 1000 volt DC should be applied between the winding and the ground. The amount of current you use depends on the rating of the machine. So this is the procedure for testing the polarization index. How to calculate the polarization index? Let's say the voltage that is applied should be kept constant for 10 minutes. An initial reading of insulation resistance is recorded at 1 minute and second reading is taken at 10 minutes. The resistance is measured consecutively and it is not necessary to take the further reading beyond 10 minutes. Now you have to take the ratio. The ratio between the 10 minute and 1 minute measurement provides the polarization index. Recommended minimum value. So if that value of polarization index is beyond a certain limit, then it means that the insulation of that electrical equipment is deteriorated and it is of no use. So we have to replace that insulator material with the new material. The recommended minimum value of the polarization index applies for both DC and AC motors and generators. The index should be at least 2.0. Machines for which index is lower are less likely to be fit for use and need to be cleaned or rebuilt or discarded. Because the index is a ratio, no units are indicated. So this is the minimum possible value of the polarization index. Now, what is the principle behind this to calculating the polarization index? The principle on which the polarization index test works is based on the idea that impurities in a winding act as charge carriers and cause a current leakage. When the insulation is tested, current leaks. These impurities can be polarized over time. The index provides indication of the amount of impurities in the winding and cleanliness of it. There is no relationship between the index and the temperature. Although there are some limitations, when attempting to the test, the index is in the high temperatures. So, I hope you understood the concept of polarization index. We have discussed the importance or the use of polarization index. We have discussed the preparation or you can say the procedure. Then we have discussed the value calculation, the recommended minimum possible value, and we have discussed the principle behind this. I hope you understood the concept. In the next class, we will discuss the important point that is called as a next related to the dielectric, and that is called as a dielectric absorption. Thank you. God bless you all.